Oh, good morning, good friends. I guess we are on time for a small hour together. Thank you to be with us. I'm Jean-François Donzier, the permanent technical secretary of IMBO, the International Network of Basin Organizations. And this workshop has a purpose to present you our next meeting in Bucharest, in Romania, and also some project where we need your help, mainly to have your opinions and your active participation for selecting some of the case studies, because we need to be very close to the field experiences to share with other members of our networks, and to be able to propose a new way for integrated river basin management. I propose, first of all, to give the floor to Elisabetta, which is coming from Romania, and she will present you an overview of our next Europe IMBO meeting, which will be held in Bucharest from 12 to 15 November 2014. Please, Elisabeth.
I'm coming from Bucharest, and I want to present a few words about the next conference. The next and 12th Europe IMBO International Conference, initiated and organized by the Group of European Basin Organization for the implementation of the Water Framework Directive in Europe, will take place this year in Bucharest, Romania, during 12 and 15 November. The conference is organized by the National Institute of Hydrology and Water Management, whose umbrella is developed the Secretariat of SEMBO also. At the invitation of the Romanian Ministry of Environment and Climate Change, Department of Water, Forest and Fishery from Romania, and also at the invitation of the National Administration of Romanian Waters, with the support of the Secretariat of SEMBO, and under the coordination of International Office of Water Paris. This year, the meeting it will be organized around four round tables and around a preparatory workshop. All these round tables and the workshop also is dealing with updated issues of the implementation of the European directive, the Water Framework Directive, Flood Directive, and other European water-related directives. Between 13 and 14 November will be the conference around the four round table, and on Wednesday, 12 November, will be the workshop River Restoration and Natural Water Retention Measures, organized in the afternoon. It's organized by the International Office of Water with the support of National Agency of Water Environment, ONEMA, from France, and the European Center for River Restoration. This preparatory workshop has a main goal to have an exchange of the practices in several countries of Europe regarding the river restoration, and also to exchange the ideas, and will take place the debates about this aspect, and to underline also the multiple benefits of this approach of the river basin management. The thematic of the river, of the four round table are round table number one, preparatory of the second river basin management plan in the framework of the Water Framework Directive, which will be developed between 2016-2021. Round table number two, natural river restoration and natural water retention measures. Number three, implementation and funding of measures. And number four, water governments in transboundary basins. For facilitate the debates and discussions of all the participants to this meeting, the organizer we assure also the simultaneous translation in French, English, Russian, and Romanian. After all this presentation and a lot of presentation and debates will be also a relaxed time for visiting the Palace of Parliament in Bucharest on Friday, and also on Saturday will be a visit, a technical visit on the Prahova River Basin, which where is situated also the Dracula Castle in at Bran. The conference is organized at the Ramada Majesty Hotel in the center of Bucharest, around a very nice sighting, and we are waiting for you to come and to be to join us and to have your presentation. Thank you.
I shall go back to some information, as I said, about different kinds of projects we have within IMBO and in close relationship with the European River Restoration Centers. Maybe for some of you who do not know exactly what is IMBO, just remember that it's now global networks, mainly oriented to develop exchange of experiences between basin organizations. And we are organized now at regional level with regional networks facilitating the direct exchange of information between basin organizations of the same continents. Just to say that, of course, the implementation of the Water Framework Directive is a key issue for us, mainly for our European Union members. And we are working a lot, very closely with the European Commissions and the Water Directors within the... Common Implementation Strategy and the group of coordinations to try to pass the problems correct on the field to allow a better implementation of the directive. As Elisabeth present, we may have a year big conference about this. This year it will be in Bucharest, in Romania, and it's mainly oriented to the implementation of the Water Framework Directive, but more and more we have to integrate also the implementation of the other European Water Directives, mainly the Flood Directive, the Nitrate Directive, and the Urban Wastewater Directive, because they are very closely linked, with also some ideas about the water scarcity and drought policy, and mainly measures to adapt to the effect of the climate change, which has been introduced in the next basin management plans for the period 2016-2021. So it will be one of our main objectives of this Bucharest meeting, to prepare the next basin management plan and speak about some other issues like natural environment, funding, and transboundary basin management also. Just to give you some overview of some link project which will be introduced also in Bucharest. We are now at the final stage of NWRM project, translate natural water retention measures. It's a project funded by the European Commissions, which regroup 11 partners, led by the International Office for Water. And the main issue is, first of all, to select or to identify good projects of natural water retention measures in the different 28 member states, to try to organize a catalog of these measures, and also to link between field practitioners to be able to develop new knowledge about this approach. It's of course directly linked to the adaptations to the effect of the climate change, and in the mind of the European Commission, it will be introduced of course as a key issue in the next basin management plan. So within the project, we identify different kind of measures which are easy to implement, which are no innovative one. They exist. We have picked up them on the field, and we try to pass the message that this exists, this is done by some of us, and it will be done also by the other. And we try to have a catalogue. It's the reason why I say we need your help. If you have some good case studies, because we do not have, of course, 100% view of what happened. We just pick up what we can. So please send these examples to us to be introduced in the catalog of case studies. But we are just at the end of the project, so please act very quickly for that. Just to say that we have identified four fields of possible implementations, of course, in urban situations. You have some view of vegetations on the roof, but not only. We have also a lot of measures facilitating the fight again, impermeabilization of the soil in the urban areas. Hydromorphology, mainly to recreate the natural flow of rivers and fight against flood. Agriculture, because it's a main issue for restoring and protecting natural areas. And of course, forestry, because it's also a key issue for retentions of water upstream. A second project I want to speak to you, but Gilles from the International Office for Water will develop a little bit more, is the new initiative of the European Commission to develop a peer review mechanisms between river basin district practitioners. The idea is to keep experts from some river basin organizations to assess another one and exchange between them on their field experiences to try to improve the next basin management plans on the experiences of the former one, because the first cycle of river basin management plans will finish next year. Gilles will come back to you with this after me. Also, some word about the preparations of the next World Water Forum. You know that it will be held in Korea, South Korea, in two towns, Daegu and Jeonju, from 12 to 17 April 2015. We are on a place between Marseille Global Forum in 2012 and the next one, which will be held in Brasilia in 2018. It will be built, as usual, around four processes of preparation: a political process involving, of course, ministerial, parliamentarian, and municipal actors, with at the end official declarations of these three key political peoples. A regional process for each region. I shall come back to you with the Europe regions, of course, because we are all European there. a thematic process and a new one, science and technology process, which is introduced by our Korean fellows for the first time. It will be, of course, interesting to follow this new process. Just to be more precise about the thematical process, we identify action goals and action tools and 16 main themes to be organized with different sessions to cover, if possible, all the fields of different kind of water issue and make a point of the knowledge, ideas, experiences, and way to go forward in each kind of these water issues. I pass rapidly, because we do not have a lot of time, but maybe you will have questions about this. Four main issues: water security for all, water for development and prosperity, water for sustainability, construction of feasible implementation mechanisms. The first one is organized about four main topics. You may have it on this. First, enough safe water for all, integrated sanitation for all, adaptation to the change, managing risk and uncertainty, and infrastructure for sustainable water resources management and services. We are mainly involved in 1.3 theme because it will be the place for speaking about adaptation to the effect of the climate change. The second I pass more rapidly because it's technical, water for food, water and energy, water and cities. There are very clear issues. Water for sustainability may be interesting for part of you, because we may have two main terms interesting and directly linked with this European River Restoration Conference. Theme 3.2, managing and restoring ecosystems, water services and biodiversity. It will be a big place for presenting our European experience. And the other 3.4, smart implementation IWRM, where we may have special sessions dealing with integrated river basin management. Economic, maybe I have also to pass rapidly, but we try to introduce three main issues. One, effective governance. It's directly linked with the Water Governance Initiative, or ECDE, and it will cover all the field of water governance. One is directly dedicated to basin management at different level, of course, local, national, and transboundary one. And we may have a special issue about cooperation, reduction of conflict, and transboundary water management, mainly dealing with big rivers. We spoke this morning with the presentation of Mike about the Rhine and Mekong. Of course, Murray Darling is some kinds of transboundary rivers because it's flowing from one to other state of Austria, which is a federal countries. The same in Brazil, for example, or in Mexico. We may have also TEM 4.5 dedicated to capacity building and education. It will be a good place for introducing new knowledge, new practices about river management in general, but also ecosystem protections and restorations. Just to say that we are also involved in parallel of this thematical process into a regional preparatory process for Europe. It's, of course, Europe at large, not only the European Union, but also the Balkans, Turkey, the candidate countries, Caucasus, and the Russian Federation. It's quite complicated to involve the Russian Federation by these days, but we try to do our best. It's managed by the French Water Partnership and the Danish Water Forum with the help of DHI and the International Office for Water. We select six main issues that we propose to present in Daegu, Jeonju, in Korea. First of all, transboundary water management, because it's a key issue for Europe at large, where we are the main number of transboundary rivers in the world, and also something to present and some success story for that. Integrated implementation of the European Union Water Directive, of course, it's very specific at our regions. Adaptation to the climate change, which will also cover the natural retention measures and some different approach of ecosystem restoration and protections. Water efficiency, more crop by drop, if you may summarize. Integrated and innovative urban water management, and science and technology for water issue in Europe. We have an internet site. We are your focal point for contact. So if you intend to participate in the next World Water Forum, it will be complicated because Korea is not just at the corner. And it's also complicated because we may have two sites in two towns in Korea. But please identify you and contact us for preparing what will be six sessions on water experiences. We may have six sessions of 2 hours, 12 hours dedicated to Europe, plus wrap-up sessions at the end with ministers, parliamentarians, and mayors of big municipality. And it will be interesting to present an overview of our ideas from European regions. Just to finish, we are also preparing two new handbooks. Maybe you have an idea of our handbooks because we prepare one in 2009 for the Istanbul World Water Forum, dedicated to integrated water resources management in basin in general. We also, for the Marseille Forum, publish a handbook for integrated water resources management in transboundary basin of river, lakes, and aquifers. This is a big success because it has been translated not only in French, English and Spanish as usual, but also in Russian, Arabic, and Chinese. Chinese, it's a good success because it's not easy to speak of transboundary basin with Chinese government. And it's translated by the official translation system of the Chinese Ministry of Water Resources, so it's a good one. So we are preparing two new handbooks, and you are invited to participate. At this moment, of course, we are a little bit short to prepare them for next April, but we are still collecting case studies. One is directly dedicated to the adaptations to the effect of the climate change of water resources. The second one is prepared also with BART and the European River Restoration Centers, dedicated to protection, restoration, management of aquatic ecosystems and the services they provide in the basin of river lakes. So you are invited to send us, if you have a small case to this, the handbook is no more than 100 pages and one field examples of very practical approach by page. So we need to have at least 100 examples, small box with a paragraph describing the purpose and the results, and of course the link to your internet site and your coordinate to be approached by people interesting that you have done. Clearly, we are also in a hurry, but we need to collect this case studies. We have a lot of them, but it would be great to have new ones if you want to participate. At the end, do you have your blue passport? I guess not yet, but it will be the future of basing citizenship. The idea is to communicate with basing stakeholders to pass the message that they are, of course, citizens of their own country, the Schengen area. We need to have our European official passport. But we are also all citizens of our basings. So we try to develop this symbol of a blue passport of your basings. It's interesting, of course, at national levels, because national rivers are also interesting. But it's also mainly interesting for transboundary rivers to give the blue passport to people. They cannot pass the border with it. But it will be very interesting to mobilize people and reinforce the idea that they are really belonging to their basics. Thank you for your attention. And I have to pass the floor mainly to Gilles to develop two KSUs, the workshop of our Bucharest meeting, and the peer review mechanisms. Thank you very much for your attention.
This workshop will be co-organized by IMBO, of course, ONEMA, which is the French National Agency for Water and Aquatic Ecosystems, and the European Center for River Restoration. This is a workshop, so something very practical about how to transfer knowledge and know-how about restoration and natural water retention measures to the practitioners. Practitioners being the target audience of the Europe IMBO meeting. We are here to transfer to the ground. And so you can see that this is all about communication on river restoration and benefits of natural water retention measures and how to mobilize stakeholders around these ideas and these practices. The workshop will be organized around a first part, which will be the introductory session, all about the recent projects connected to river restoration, including this conference. And the outcomes of this conference will be transferred to the practitioners during the workshop. And we will get also feedback from the Restore project. Then, two working groups about two topics, and including case studies to introduce the topics, and then working groups about questions, and to see how we could work together to answer or try to answer to these questions. My German is not that good, so some difficulties. The topic number one is how to integrate European directives and policies through river restoration measures and NWRM. And you can see the questions which are foreseen to link an exchange between different sectors of activity to integrate the different policies, how to communicate to the river basin managers and other stakeholders on the benefits of river restoration, how to mobilize and convince the partners from out of the water box, what we usually said, agriculture and industries and so, to be involved in the restoration project to give them better or greater benefits. And the question of the scale of the projects. Do we need to work at small scale? And will those small projects give a large benefits, or do we need to work at a large scale with real benefits? The second question is about the better engagement with the local communities in the restoration project. And you see the questions, how to mobilize the elected people, the officials, locally for river restoration, how to involve the local communities, what tools could be are available and could be used for that, and last but not least, how to mobilize financing for river restoration projects. And of course, you are kindly invited to participate. The target is water managers, the people involved in the day-to-day management of river basin, but we need experts. We need people having some knowledge and know-how to transfer. So you are welcome in Bucharest on the 12th of November. That is very close, but Bucharest in November is a very nice place to be. So you are welcome. Thank you for that. Yes. Then the peer review mechanism. This is something that has been pushed by the European Commission, DG Environment, to improve the second round of the implementation of river basin management plans and the improvement of the implementation of the Water Framework Directive, of course. The consortium leading this activity is led by Office International de l'Eau, International Office for Water, together with the National Administration of Romanian Waters and its Hydrology Institute, together with IMBO, and involving also the different regional branches of IMBO, the European one, and the Eastern and Central European one. The third partner, the last partner, is the MEMBO, the Mediterranean branch of IMBO. Then, perhaps you remember that in the blueprint issued by the Commission in 2012, it was said that a simple voluntary peer review system would help a basin to improve what they did during the first round to better prepare river basin management plans and to get stock of the know-how of other basin in their own basin. Because the quality of river the first river management plans were not so was not the same in all countries, in all basins. This exercise is an exercise of mutual learning, to take the benefit from the people in advance, to see how to not implement like this ideas, but to adapt ideas in each basin, and to try to improve those plan management plans. So, the peer review mechanism has to be simple, voluntary, targeted, and oriented to mutual learning between peers. This is very important. And you see the targeted people are practitioners from districts and their competent authorities. How? We will organize peer review missions in receiving competence authority. So we have to, and all on a voluntary basis. So we have to identify competent authorities from districts who want to be reviewed, who want to get external advice on what they did, and to who want to discuss with peers to better improve their own practices. So what can be reviewed? The management plan. So the management plan, that's this, the steps of planification, the management, the public consultation, participative process, the monitoring, the information systems, and of course technical issues regarding all the components of the Water Framework Directive. That can be sectoral approaches, that can be integration of policies, or what is needed. The idea is to ask to the competent authorities who want to benefit from the peer review what they need. Not to say, okay, you were wrong or you were bad on this topic, so you need a peer review. No, the process is to ask them to be candidate for the peer review and to identify by themselves where they need peer assistance. So what we will do, we will launch calls for expression of interest by the to the district authorities, and they will be volunteer to say, okay, I need some, or I would like to get some advice, some help on this and that topic. They will define, with the help of the secretariat, of course, the terms of reference of the peer review. And on the other hand, the secretariat will identify and also do a call for expression of interest, identify experts or peer reviewers who will be volunteer to help their colleagues and to discuss with their colleagues. Those experts will have to come from public authorities. That is a restriction given by the DG environment. So they are unlikely to be consultants. They can be peers from competent authorities, from river basin organizations, from universities, but not consultants. The process is to be really not on a commercial basis of I am a consultant, I give you an advice, I give you the solution. The idea is to have peer exchanges and to do really learning, co-learning, and to help the local people to find themselves their solution. So we will have procedures for matchmaking experts and the receiving competent authorities. Then we will define procedures and we will define rules for the peer review process, organize missions on the ground to have a really peer-to-peer discussions, peer-to-peer exchanges. And then the experts will elaborate their report about what they saw, what they proposed, their recommendations, and so on and so. We will use webinars to have discussions between the experts and the receiving authorities after the issue of the draft report, to be sure that we all speak the same language and that everybody understands everybody. And then we will have dissemination activities and so. Of course, dissemination will not be wide dissemination. We will not disseminate the report made by an expert to the world. If they say, okay, this has to be improved, this will be kept by the receiving competent authority as an internal document. Confidentiality will be respected. The agenda, we started in September 2014. The manual of procedures is about to be ready. The manual of procedures will be reviewed by the SCG, The SCG is the Strategic Coordination Group, which is linked to the CIS, the Common Implementation Strategy of the Water Framework Directive. And this group is made of NGOs and different stakeholders involved in the implementation of the Water Framework Directive. And those people will review the manual of procedures to improve it. And we should launch the call for expression of interest for the river basin districts and the experts in next January. So if you are an expert from a public authority, you are welcome to be a candidate. And if you work in a river basin district and you think that there are some weaknesses in your approach of the river basin management plan, you are welcome to candidate also for this process. Or to say to you, to the director, to the general manager of the basin organization that you could. So we will be able to provide the timetable of the first peer reviews in next January after the collection of the first candidates. And to get some feedback on the first peer reviews in next spring. We are supposed to do that within the next 2 years. So the time is not so long. So this has to be done very quickly. Very quickly. Why? Because the river management plans are supposed to be ready by the end of 2015. So we are kind of a hurry to do that. And yes, the target is to review 2020 river management plan. There are a lot of materials which will be issued or which are under review now that you can get on this website address, aquacope.org peer review. And if you need further information, if you need to know when the call will be issued or whatever you need, please send us a message to this p.review@oeo.fr. And I guess that's all. Yeah.